there, 3-2. So it will be interesting to see when the halves does go. As Woody gets pistol there with the 47, Stephen Mr. takes that edge there, and Snow responds onto Stephen. So it is a 2-on-3 situation. Good reaction time from him there. Good to see he can see into the middle of A. He does get lots of fire. Snow takes out Zantic, lots of fire going through the bottom. Oh, and Snow responds onto Eclipse. Snow goes large, and Snow again onto Lantern. Snow has just gone absolutely massive that round.
But Tato manages to escape. Can he get into that sniper spot that everybody loves when they want to defend the bombsite? Yes, he can. They're not looking for him. He's going to get up there. That is some great work from him. He sees the player take the plant shot. Yes, he takes out W2F. It's all up to Retired. Retired's going to go heading towards him. He can hear Tato reloading the sniper rifle up top. He's going to have to do the slow walk up. He does so. He's you could cut the air with a knife. He's going to have to make his way back to the bomb. Yes, he's acknowledged it. He roars on and takes out the player. He's got a 5-second sprint to get down to the bomb. That is great work from Retired. Defuse time. Now we're on the stress time. He's going to go for the defuse. Can he get it for the snapback crew?
Yeah, he'll hose in. In the end, it is a good piece of work from Retired. The quiet ladder crawl was all that was required. He got it in the end. And holy crap, B-Ray, you could cut the air with a knife. That was a stunner around from him.
Yeah.
down. Vache with the SMZ. Paney on the anomaly there. Now the A does go down there. Hectic got a Paney controlling A now, pushing the bottom A. Oh, Crank goes down there. Hectic pushing even deeper. Takes out one, takes out two. Frames with D2 with the deck. Hectic in the house. Absolute shreds now. And we do see Kessler just trying to hold on to that health there, sitting over on the A side, and a bit of a cheeky laugh now as he manages to escape, getting shot to bits. And now holding the mic, focusing on the A side. Now Snow picks up Kessler there, sits a couple tags on him. Not going to be quite enough now though, as we do hear plenty of action heading over towards the red room now, and it is Woody trying to get some hit fire onto, I think that was Cyril's, I don't know. Oh, Snow coming to the rescue. Bit cheeky there, Woody, just trying to bait him out. And there we go, Holgan onto Woody there. So he's come out of A and decided he's going to take things into his own hands. And does he ever? Now he goes down to Snow though. And Snow's going to make his way over perhaps to the B. Now he's heading to Tank Room. He's going to run into someone out of spawn now. Catches him by surprise. Snow with another one there. He's had four this round. Can he make it a 1v5 here? We're going to see him get a plant down. And the Mic Master has to make his way to the B side and try and stop this one, Arcee. It's going to be a big one now. As Snow picks a box. Pick a box, any box. He's going to set himself up inside the B site and just try and jump out and ambush Mike. This could be big, a massive impact round for Arcanum, and I'm sure it'll be a morale booster as well, especially when the game is as tight as it has been. Snow pops out from behind, the box is not quite good enough though. No hit fire action from the Mike man, and Snow makes it a team down. Lovely clutch work there. That is how you lead a team. 8-4 it is. Oh, got shivers from that one.
Three rounds is very, very easy to pick up on this map in particular when you're on defense. As Snow takes out Holden to at least give me some credit for my caller. Snow takes out Kessler. His push through the mid has been a stunner. He is lonesome. Proud of an 100 meter deck out the back, but lonesome on his push, and he takes out Nate. He'll take out Mike, and it'll be the Snow show with Woody grabbing the fifth, and it'll be 14 rounds to 7, and that's pretty much says the game.